Here we go. Okay. Yes. Under 12.
Under 12 degrees. Horizontally.
Yes. Oh, yeah. This is good. This is has a way better binocular overlap than the Quest 3. I think the Quest 3 probably also has like 110 or so. But it's totally worse because here you have a really good binocular overlap.
Tell me, what's more important to you when buying the next VR headset? A wide field of view or a wide binocular overlap? Preferably both, right? Well, it's not that easy. Let me clarify. Field of view is how much of the virtual world you can see at once. Binocular overlap or stereo overlap is the part of the view seen by both eyes simultaneously. Both field of view and binocular overlap in VR are directly correlated with each other. If you widen the field of view, then the binocular overlap will be affected, and in most cases, the overlap gets narrower. Now, if you do increase the field of view too far by sacrificing too much of the overlap, your vision can get disconnected, like your eyes aren't really working together, causing nausea or eye discomfort, among other side effects. That is the reason why Pimax and the other VR brands must balance the field of view and binocular overlap to keep the experience as immersive and natural as possible. And until now, each company have settled for one single balanced distortion profile that either prioritizes field of view or overlap without compromising the other too much. Eventually, that also determines the headset's final and the advertised field of view. In my last videos, I presented the field of view and binocular overlap values for both the Dream Air Micro-OLED DVT sample in its current development stage, as well as the Crystal Super and its latest Micro-OLED optical engine soon to be shipped. Some people loved the fact that the field of view I presented was indeed impressive on both headsets, 116 degrees versus 110 degrees horizontally. But another part of our VR community got concerned when they realized that the binocular overlap values were 82 and 84 degrees respectively. But here comes the good news. What if we let you decide whether you prefer to run a wider field of view or if you rather maximize the binocular overlap, giving you the freedom to make that choice without buying multiple VR headsets? Well, that's the plan. That's what Pimax is aiming for, and that is also what we can expect becoming a feature within Pimax Play software. And while this feature is not yet implemented, of course, already now I'm able to switch between three existing and different profiles for my Crystal Super Micro OLED, which the engineers are currently testing. There are probably more than three profiles available at the office, but three profiles is what I got here, and the same thing will be possible for the Dream Air. And this is also why I'm making this video, to demonstrate that it works. Anyway, so I've got three profiles here. The first one is the same I used when making my last Super Micro OLED Impressions video back at the Pimax headquarters. It offers 116 degrees of horizontal field of view, 88 vertically, 118 degrees diagonally, and with a binocular overlap of 84 degrees, which translates to approximately 73% binocular overlap. Now let me show you the second profile for the Super Micro OLED. With one single file replaced, I now see 103 degrees of horizontal field of view, while the vertical field of view stays the same at 88 degrees. But the binocular overlap is now 95 degrees. Yes, 95 degrees of stereo overlap, which you can also clearly see here while checking the VR mirror view and doing field of view test in the Test HMD application. That translates to right above 92% binocular overlap. meaning 92% of what you see in VR is seen in stereo by both your eyes simultaneously. When testing the third profile I got here, we're suddenly looking at some crazy numbers. 107 degrees of horizontal field of view. Sure, that is lower than 116 degrees originally, but now we see 113 degrees of vertical field of view reported. Although, I must say this, for some reason I do only see around 96 degrees vertically here with my eyes, so I guess that profile still needs to be tweaked. But then, 99 degrees of binocular overlap. That is almost 93% overlap in total, meaning that almost your entire field of view in VR is seen by both eyes. Again, not only does this add to the VR immersion, seeing stereo view almost all the way to the edges on the left and right side, but it also helps a lot of people to prevent motion sickness, nausea, and eye fatigue. Not for everyone, maybe. For example, not for me, but at least people who are more sensitive to this, like MRTV Sebastian, for example. And this is not it, because Pimax engineers are currently working on the more and better profiles even for both Crystal Super Micro-OLED and the Dream Air. Oh, and one more thing to cover here, the resolutions and performance difference. With the first profile I showed you, the base resolution or the rendered resolution, when having Pimax Play render quality or image quality set to 1.0, the resolution is then 5352x4088 pixels per eye. Some quick math and we'll see almost 22 million pixels per eye or nearly 44 million pixels rendered in total. An impressively high number, but also still nice on your GPU, because it gives you tons of more performance or GPU headroom in comparison to the resolution required when running Crystal Super 50 PPD module at Pimax Play 1.0, which renders 6240 by 6280 pixels per eye, or 39 million pixels per eye, which translates to 78 million pixels in total, almost twice the number of pixels rendered on the 50 PPD. Although it's impressive, I would say that the 50 PPD optical engine isn't really optimized for performance, and this is also the reason I'm honestly not a big fan of it. I made a video on this recently, comparing the frame rate performance difference between almost all Crystal Super modules and even the Crystal Lite and the original Crystal. The Micro OLED module and the 57 PPD module were the two best performing and giving you, under certain conditions, between 30 and 50% higher frame rates in DCS world in that example. Now, when running the second profile for the Crystal Super Micro OLED, the one giving us 103 degrees of horizontal field of view, 88 degrees vertically, and 95 degrees of binocular overlap, it gets even better. The rendered resolution at Pimax Play 1.0 is now 4984 by 4088 pixels per eye. That's roughly 40 million pixels for both eyes, which is 4 million pixels less than the first profile. That is roughly 10% less pixels, which usually equals to another 10% better performance or 10% higher frame rate in VR games. Yeah, you may point out that we lost 12% field of view with this profile, going from 116 to 103 degrees only, but remember, we also gained roughly 13% more binocular overlap and potentially 10% better performance. With the third profile, it's a different story. At Pimax Play Image Quality 1.0, the Super Micro OLED renders 5356 by 6492 pixels per eye. Yeah, quite a big number of pixels, especially vertically. Almost 35 million pixels per eye, or 70 million pixels in total. It's still 8 million pixels less than what the 50 PPD renders in total, which is 78 million pixels. So we get a huge binocular overlap, a wider vertical field of view using this profile on the Super Micro OLED over the first profile. But it's definitely not as beneficial anymore performance-wise. Having all that said, this is not it. There will be other profiles available soon, that's for sure. I do also believe that we will see a vertical field of view reaching visible 100 degrees or so with an upcoming profile. I kind of bet on that. I truly believe that this is a game changer for a lot of people. Being able to prioritize maximum field of view over binocular overlap or the other way around gives you options that you normally need to pay for by owning multiple headsets. While here, it's all baked in. And what do you think about this? Do you prefer a bigger binocular overlap or a wider field of view? And why? Let us know in the comments. That's all I have for today. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.